हेलो गाइस, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ एहसन रियाज एंड वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एआई टेक्निक्स। टुडे इज़ आवर लेक्चर 11 ऑफ पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग कोर्स एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल टीच यू व्हाइल लूप इन पाइथन। व्हाट इज़ व्हाइल लूप? इन व्हाइल लूप एवरी टाइम अ कंडीशन इज एवेल्युएटेड एंड वी चेक इफ अ कंडीशन इज ट्रू देन वी एग्जीक्यूट द लूप बॉडी, अदरवाइज वी स्टॉप द लूप। व्हाइल लूप डिपेंड अपॉन True state condition. First one is condition. When the condition is true, then while loop will be executed. And second one is variable value. When the condition of the while loop become false by due to changing of variable, then we stop the while loop. What is syntax of while loop? This is syntax of while loop. We use first initialize a variable set counter and write while in small letters and write condition here and write statement with intent. And this is the flowchart for while loop. First we enter to while loop body and first we check condition. If the condition is true, then we execute the loop body and we repeat it, and second time we check it again. If the condition is true, then we execute loop body again, and if the condition is false, then we stop the loop. And during the while loop, we also change the value of variable set counter value. Now let, for example, if I want to display number from 1 to 5 using while loop, it can be possible. First I will initialize a variable counter, say counter is equal to 1, and use while counter less than equal to 5 and print the counter values, and counter is equal to counter plus 1. This loop body will execute from 1 to 5, and every time counter value is updated one by one, which means the first value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be printed on the screen. When the value of counter will become 6, then this loop body will stop. And after, when the while loop stop, then we can also check exit of while loop will be printed on the screen. Let's solve example with while loop. First I will write this problems on the PyCharm. First I will write display your name 5 times using while loop. There is a mistake. I will update it. We want to display our name with while loop. Let me open all these program which we need. And second program is find factorial of a number using while loop. And third is write a program to find number of digits in a number. If number is, let's say, 52, then digits are 5 and 2, which means total digits are 2. If number is 621, then total digits are 3 and so on. And fourth and last program is write a program to find the sum of digits of given number. For example, 1 and 4 is a number, then if we divide these digits 1 plus 4, then its sum is 5. We will solve all these problems. Let's open our PyCharm. Let me copy paste this now. I will first comment this code and write all the solution one by one. First question is display your name. 5 times using while loop. First I will store a variable, declare a variable name and write my name as in. Now I will use while loop. While, as we know that while loop uses any variable before starting while loop, we will initialize counter. We want to print our name from 5 times, so I will use counter variable, and I will use condition counter less than equal to 5, and I will print name, and this will print 5 times my name, but we are missing one time, because every time counter value is same, so we need to increment the values. Counter is equal to counter plus 1. If you know I run my program, you can see counter is, you know, program is displayed and SN is printed 5 times. I can also check value of counter to confirm my program is correct or not. You can see value of are corrected. Our program is working perfectly. Now I will do second program, which is find the factorial of a given number. First I will comment over my old code, or if you can comment or uncomment, it is your choice. Now I will find factorial of a given number using while loop. First I will take a number from user, enter a number. Now we will typecast it into int. Now I will use a variable. Now I want to find factorial. As you know that factorial is get by its number, decrement the value and all up to the 1 and multiply all these numbers. For example, 5, then we will decrement all 1 by 1 and we will multiply all these values, which is will equal to factorial. Now I will do it with using while loop. First I will declare a variable counter. Now we will use while loop while counter less than equal to given number. So first it will 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5. If I write 5, then it will 5. It will execute 5 times. When it will become 6, then it will be store. I will store factorial in a variable. First I will store answer 1 here, and now I will every time we will multiply number with factorial. Now we will decrement the value increment the value of counter, which first it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and up to n number which we have enter. After this body loop, I will print the value of factorial, or just print num, or I will use now I will print and run our program. First it will ask me enter a number. I will enter 3. Sorry, there is a mistake. Let's see. Actually we cannot use this because number is integer. We have to typecast it. So I will use a integer comma. Now we will run our program and type again. Now you can see 3 factorial is is equal to 4. So here we want to print factorial value, and we will write factorial of given number is equal to factorial. Now run our program again and type 3. What is happening? Actually there is a mistake. We should multiply with counter node with the number. Sorry, there is a mistake. Now I will write 3 and we'll check. Now you can see factorial of 3 is 6, because 3 multiplied by 2, 2 multiplied by 1, which is equal to 6. Now if I write, if I input 6, 4, then it will be 24. Our program is not correct. Now I will write third program, which is at a program to find, which is write a program to find the number of digits in a number. If the number is 5, 2, then digits is 2. First I will input number from user, enter a number. And we will convert it into int, digit type. Now we want to get number of digits. I will declare a variable 0, count, and initialize it with 0, and we will divide number until the number is 0. So until the number is positive, let's divide our first. I will, every time we are in the loop, word loop, we will increment the value of count, and we will divide the number by 10, and we will typecast it to int, and we will use double integer operator, which is integer division, and after this we can also print our count value, which is number of digits in num. We can also make a backup of these values by using temp. I can print this. Now run our program. First I will write 3, and you can see number of digits in 3 is R. In 3 there are total 1 digit, which is 3. If I write 315, no digits are 3. If I write 25, no digits are 2. If I write 520, 523, no digits are 6. Our program is working perfectly. Now I will note last program is write a program to find the sum of digits of a given number. In program 3, we find total number of digits. We can also use this program to find the sum of digits, but we will change something. Instead of, we will use some extra line to achieve this. First I will comment above code. Now I will take a number from user, then we will use the same code, and now instead of count we will use sum, and instead of count plus is equal to count plus 1, we will use sum is equal to sum plus, and we will use num mod 10. Every time we will take the mod of number by 10, and we can find easily the sum of the digits of number. Now you can print it. Sum, yeah, we can write here sum of digits of given number. We can write here is, now we will print. If I write 1, 2, then it should be 3. The sum of digits of given number 1, 2 is 3. No. Check another case. I write 1 to 5. Sorry. No. No. Sum should be 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. Sorry. If I enter, no, sum should be 8, which is correct. No, I will write a different value. Let's say 0. Sum is 0. If I write 1 0 0 2 0 and 1, no, press enter. Now you can see the sum of the digits are 1 plus 2 is equal to 3 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, and all other are 0. If we sum with 0, then its sum will remain same. So number of the sum of digits is 4. That is all our today lecture. Hope you guys enjoy this video. If you are new on this channel, kindly subscribe this channel. I will make a Python class course series in future, and if you subscribe my channel, you will not miss any video related to Python programming course or any other video. I will meet you in the next video. Thank you.